Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 23rd of July. Have to vigorously fight coronavirus till vaccine comes, says Indian PM Modi as cases cross 1.2 million. US condemns deadly airstrikes in Afghanistan's Herat province. And Pakistan administered Kashmir's PM says don't have single penny for healthcare workers. And now for all the details. As India's COVID-19 cases tally crossed the 1.2 million mark on Thursday, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi said we have to fight vigorously against the virus till the vaccine comes. He also said that Northeast India is dealing with the twin challenge of combating the coronavirus and floods, which have caused huge damages and claimed several lives.
As India's cases tally crossed the 1.2 million mark, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday said, "We have to fight vigorously against the coronavirus till the vaccine comes." Speaking at the virtual foundation stone laying ceremony of a major water supply project in northeastern Manipur province, Modi said the northeast India in particular is dealing with a twin challenge of combating coronavirus and devastating floods. Floods due to heavy rainfall in India's northeastern Assam province have claimed 89 lives so far and caused huge damages, while millions have been affected. Modi expressed sympathies to the affected families and assured all help. India on Thursday registered highest one-day spike of 45,720 new cases and a record 1,129 people succumbed to the fatal disease in the past 24 hours, taking the country's cases tally to 1,238,635 with 29,861 deaths so far.
जब तक वैक्सीन नहीं आती है, जहां कोरोना के खिलाफ हमें मजबूती से लड़ते रहना है, विजयी होना है, वहीं विकास के कार्यों को भी पूरी ताकत से आगे बढ़ाना है। इस बार तो पूर्वी और उत्तर पूर्वी भारत को एक तरह से दोहरी चुनौतियों से निपटना पड़ रहा है।
As several provinces in India reported record jumps in daily coronavirus cases on Wednesday, lockdown restrictions of different durations were clamped in northern Kashmir Valley, central Bhopal and northeastern Manipur as well. Despite rising cases, India's recovery rate now stands at 63.18%.
The two-day India Idea Summit organized by the US-India Business Council featured high-level presence of Indian and US government policymakers and leaders from business and society, pitching India's rise as a country with increasing openness and one that the world can trust. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi told US investors on Wednesday that there has never been a better time to invest in India. The two-day India Idea Summit organized by the US-India Business Council was held virtually on 21st and 22nd July. The summit brought together officials from the two nations who are setting the post-coronavirus recovery agenda. While delivering the keynote address at the summit on Wednesday, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi asked US firms to invest in India, pointing to the ways the government is facilitating investors and the promising growth in various sectors, including infrastructure, aviation, defense, and space research. While delving into various key facets of the fast expanding ties between the two countries, India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar said India and the US need to think bigger while attempting to resolve the pending trade issues.
I think the US really has to learn to work in a sense with a more multipolar world, with more plurilateral arrangements, go beyond alliances with which really it has grown up over the last two generations.
Mark Warner, Democratic senator from Virginia and co-chair of the Senate India Caucus, a discussant in the panel with Jaishankar, called for a technological alliance of the willing to counter China's domination in the field.
Moving on, the United States has condemned the airstrikes conducted by the Afghan Air Force in western province of Herat that left multiple civilians dead. U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad also slammed the Taliban Islamist group for recent attacks that also resulted in many civilian deaths.
U.S. Special Representative for Afghanistan Reconciliation Zalmay Khalilzad on Thursday condemned the airstrikes conducted by the Afghan Air Force in the western province of Herat that left multiple civilians dead. Taking to Twitter, Khalilzad said, "The last 24 hours have been very violent in Afghanistan, with many losing their lives. In Herat, photos and eyewitnesses' accounts suggest many civilians, including children, are among the victims of an Afghan airstrike. We condemn the attack and support an investigation." According to reports, airstrikes in eastern Afghanistan killed 45 people, including civilians and Taliban fighters. Khalilzad also slammed the Taliban Islamist group for recent attacks that also resulted in many civilian deaths, saying, "The Afghan people want an immediate start of peace negotiations and a settlement that is in their best interest." Despite the US-Taliban peace agreement, which was signed in Doha on February 29, the situation in Afghanistan has remained volatile, with sporadic attacks by both Afghan forces and the Taliban on each other.
In news from Sri Lanka, Sri Lanka's President Gotabaya Rajapaksa on Wednesday vowed to free the country from drug menace while campaigning for the candidates of his party, Sri Lanka Podujana Perumuna. Sri Lanka is slated to hold parliamentary elections on 5th of August, more than 3 months late because of the coronavirus outbreak.
Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa on Wednesday said he will free the country from the drug menace for the future generation, the same way it was freed from terrorism. Addressing an election rally to campaign for Sri Lanka Podujana Peramuna or SLPP candidates, the president said several measures are already in place to prevent drug infiltration and distribution. Sri Lanka is set to hold the parliamentary elections on 5th of August, more than 3 months late because of the coronavirus outbreak. Chairman of the Election Commission Mahinda Deshapriya has assured that a number of health guidelines will be followed during the parliamentary elections, and there is no reason for voters to be afraid. The Election Commission had earlier said the cost for the election will be 50% higher because of the precautionary measures needed to be taken. As of Thursday, Sri Lanka reported 2,730 confirmed cases of coronavirus, with 11 deaths so far. Around 2,064 patients have been cured and discharged.
In news from Pakistan, Marriage Hall Association in Pakistan's port city of Karachi held a protest highlighting the pathetic condition of the marriage hall owners as their business was closed due to COVID-19 for the last 4 months. Pakistan government has opened several businesses with SOPs, but marriage halls have not been allowed to open.
Marriage Hall Association in Pakistan's Karachi city held protest demonstration against closure of their business in the provincial metropolis and asked the government to reopen marriage halls, lawns and banquets under standard operating procedures or SOPs. Hundreds of owners and workers of the association gathered at the Karachi Press Club, carrying placards and banners to highlight their plight that they were facing financial crisis due to closure of their business. Wedding halls were closed during the lockdown imposed to curb the coronavirus pandemic, and public gathering restrictions forbid the operation of their business. Khwaja Tariq, Secretary General of the association, warned to expand the protest and march if their demands were not met.
It is the only industry that has been closed for 4 months. हम अपनी इंडस्ट्री से जुड़े 6.5 लाख दिहाड़ीदार तबके और खानदानों के लिए आवाज उठाने के लिए आए हैं। हम बिलावल भुट्टो जरदारी साहब से, इमरान खान साहब से सवाल करते हैं कि ये वही दिहाड़ीदार तबका है जिसके लिए आप इलेक्शन में आवाज उठाते हैं, आज हम इनके लिए अमली तौर पे आवाज उठाने के लिए आए हैं। तो
हमने एप्लीकेशन अपीलें दी हैं, रिसीव करवाई हैं, अब तक हमसे कोई रब्ता नहीं किया। इन्होंने हमसे आखिरी बात जो की थी वो 24 रमजान को की थी, उसके बाद इन्होंने तमाम बेसिक SOPs के साथ तमाम कारोबारों को इन्होंने ब्रीथिंग स्पेस दिया है, हमारे कारोबार को नहीं खोला। क्या ये समझते हैं मंडी को खोल के, क्या हम लोग जानवर से बदतर है?
The protest comes as the country struggles to contain a renewed spike in COVID-19 cases after initial restrictions were eased in May to allow certain public gathering activities. As of Thursday, Pakistan reported 269,191 confirmed coronavirus cases and over 5,700 deaths.
Doctors and healthcare workers have been working hard to fight the coronavirus outbreak in Pakistan-administered Kashmir, but they have been left demoralized as their demand for pay hike is being denied. Raja Farooq Haider Khan, the Prime Minister of Pakistan-administered Kashmir, has said that he does not have a single penny to support doctors and other staff.
Prime Minister of Pakistan-administered Kashmir, Raja Farooq Haider Khan, has said that he does not have a single penny to support doctors and paramedical staff in the illegally occupied region. Doctors and other healthcare workers have been demanding pay hike at par with their counterparts in other parts of Pakistan and have blamed stepmotherly treatment by Islamabad as a primary cause of the misery. Locals have long accused there is a prime minister and president in Pakistan-administered Kashmir, but they are merely stooges who have been helping Islamabad fill its treasuries through economic depredation.
अब मेरे पास कोई पैसा ये छोटी कोड़ी नहीं है कि जिससे मैं इनके मुताबिक इनकी मतलब ये बक बढ़ा सकूं। ये अब सिर्फ डॉक्टर नहीं है, उधर डॉक्टर 1,000 हैं, 9,000 पैरामेडिक्स हैं, उसके वो नहीं मांगेंगे, पेंशनर्स नहीं मांगेंगे, दूसरे नहीं मांगेंगे, मैं कहां से लाऊंगा?
Absence of medical facilities has also remained a matter of grave concern in Pakistan-administered Kashmir, but healthcare workers have claimed that in the fight against coronavirus, they also lack testing kits and proper safety gear.
Ahead of the sibling festival of Raksha Bandhan next month, the demand for Chinese Rakhis, the sacred thread tied on the wrist of brothers by sisters, have fallen this year. People are refusing to buy Chinese Rakhis due to tensions between India and China after 20 Indian soldiers were killed in clashes with Chinese troops.
The demand for China-made Rakhis has gone down ahead of the Hindu sibling festival of Raksha Bandhan. Rakhis are sacred threads that are tied on the wrist of the brothers by their sisters to symbolize their strong bond. Residents in India's western Vadodara city who flocked the markets were looking for Indian-made Rakhis as an anti-China sentiment swept the country. Shopkeepers also said they were not ordering Chinese Rakhis as customers were refusing to purchase those items.
मैं अभी राखी परचेज करने के लिए आई हूँ, तो मैं वही राखी जो हमारे यहाँ पे इंडिया में बनी हुई है, हमारा खुद का मैन्युफैक्चर होना चाहिए, क्योंकि जिस तरीके से अभी चाइनीज का जो चल रहा है चाइना के साथ, हमारा कितने शहीद हमारे सैनिक हुए हैं, तो उसको देख के हम यही प्रिपेयर करेंगे कि हमारे खुद का यहाँ पे बना हुआ ही प्रोडक्ट हम
कि वो लोगों का माल लेना। अभी पब्लिक को ऐसा है, जितना सब प्रॉब्लम चल रहा है, बॉर्डर पे प्रॉब्लम चढ़ता है, वायरस का प्रॉब्लम है, तो लोग मना ही करते हैं और हम भी मंगाते नहीं हैं, जितना हो सके उतना नहीं मंगाने की कोशिश करते हैं।
मीनवाइल वुमेन इन इंडियाज नॉर्दर्न वाराणसी सिटी वेयर मेकिंग राखीज टू प्रमोट प्रोडक्ट्स मेड इन द कंट्री। दे आल्सो इंटेंड टू बूस्ट द इंडियन इकोनॉमी बाय बाइंग एंड सेलिंग लोकल राखीज। मेनी हैव डिसाइडेड टू बॉयकॉट मेड इन चाइना प्रोडक्ट्स ड्यू टू टेंशंस बिटवीन इंडिया एंड चाइना After 20 Indian soldiers were killed in clashes with Chinese troops in northern Galwan Valley. Both countries have blamed each other for triggering the clash, the deadliest between the neighbors in at least 5 decades.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.